I think it's probably, without a doubt, the greatest thing that's ever happened to this county. I think it's something that will go down in the annals of time. And I just hope that when it's all said and done, that the people of Charlotte County will appreciate it, as well the people of entire Southside Virginia.
With the movie being shot here in Charlotte County, that probably will add to the tourism later. I know for the last few days it's been quite a bit, and some days we've just had so many people coming in, and I think this is just great for Charlotte County, and I'm sure it's helped local economy very much.
Absolutely beautiful here. The town, the people are so friendly, and the countryside is so beautiful. I really like it here a lot.
I'm R.B. Clark, Charlotte County Administrator, and with me is my assistant, Stephanie Heinzelman. And we have had the pleasure over the last several days of being a part of a very exciting project. The filming of a major motion picture here in Charlotte County. The name of the film is Summersby. It's been quite an experience for all of us. Many of our people have participated. And I think that our clerk of the circuit court, Stuart Fallon, who's out on the set now, could best tell you how it all originated.
Middle of January, we had a young man come through the courthouse with a camera. Came into my office and asked if he could possibly take a picture of the courthouse. And thinking that he was probably a genealogist or just a tourist coming through, we said, sure, take a picture. So he goes up, takes a couple of pictures, and then about 3 or 4 days later, he came back with the pictures developed and said that he had taken these to a production company. They liked what they saw, and they were wondering if they maybe could use the courthouse in the movie.
My name is Anna Craven. I'm the assistant location manager for the movie, Summersby. It's a Richard Gere, Jodie Foster film that's a post-Civil War love story. It's set in Tennessee, and we've been filming in Virginia since about, early April, and going to go on until, I think, June 30th is our cutoff date. But what we're doing in Charlotte Courthouse, specifically, is the courthouse footage. It's going to be a big trial. We have James Earl Jones as our judge, Richard Gere, of course, playing Jack Summersby, Jodie Foster is playing Laurel Summersby, and we've got cast of thousands and extras, many of which are Charlotte County residents. What you're going to see now, we're in the courtroom itself, use that as a backdrop and then just run you guys through a few of the bits that we're doing. For instance, from where I'm standing now, you can see the judge's bench, the back wall. Now, we like the look of the courthouse the way it was, so we kept, we kind of kept the idea and made some surface changes. For instance, we painted or marbleized the backdrop to the judge's bench, added some woodwork, marbleized the pillars that you see here. We added new pews, new chairs, new railing, painted the walls a bit of a different color so that it would cut down on the white reflection of our light and make it look a little more dirtied, reconstruction, aged, that type thing. The movie crew itself is about 100 plus people, and then we've employed about 110 Charlotte, well, extras, many of which, like I've said, are from Charlotte County. That in and of itself is like a friendly army coming into a specific area. Hotel rooms, we did the restaurants. We go out into the community on our one day off and play, basically, is what we do. So there's a real good, strong economic impact when a company like this comes into town. We've rented office space, for instance, from one of the local folks here. Of course, we cooperate with the county itself and have hired the sheriff and some of his deputies, the off-duty guys, to work with us on traffic control, things of that nature. So we employ a lot of the folks in the county. It's a very, very short time. It's only about 10 days or so. But prior to our filming, we were even here setting up our wardrobe and setting up our production office and employing security to guard those buildings and things of that nature. So as you can see, there's a pretty strong drop of money in the community prior to filming itself, and then the wrap out, when we take all the walls down and take the dirt up and repaint the walls or whatever. That's really one of the most positive things about a movie crew coming into any area. Now, we've also earned a pretty good reputation filming in Bath County, Lexington, and now here in Charlotte County, where not only in our employing people or working with them economically, but also socially, you know, going out to the restaurants, entertaining the community, working with them, inviting them to come watch us film. We have to establish parameters, but I think they've had a pretty good time doing that. Just some of the more positive points about the movie coming to a particular area. Not to mention the fact that with stars like Richard Gere and Jodie Foster and James Earl Jones, you're going to have a pretty good turnout from other areas that come in and buy sodas from the pharmacy and buy from the stores or stay in a hotel in order to stay over and maybe catch a glimpse of the star. So there's a lot of roundabout ways that that we impact a community in a very positive manner. Now, speaking of the stars briefly, we have James Earl Jones, who's playing Judge Isaacs. He's presiding over this trial.
You are not Jack Summersby, so why do you keep going on pretending that you are?
How do you know I'm not?
I know because...
How do you know, Laura?
I know because...
How do you know?
I know because I never loved him the way that I love you.
A man who was whatever he believed he was.
Jodie Foster plays his wife. She's here, full support group. She, of course, is in love with him, does not want to see him fare badly in the trial. So she's here, full support for that. Those are the main characters. We do have also, for instance, Maury Chaykin, who many of you will know as the suicidal captain, I believe, in Dances with Wolves. So we have quite a few characters here with us. William Wyndham is from Murder, She Wrote. We have him with us. He's been there from the beginning. He plays Jodie's father, Reverend Powell. Oh gosh, there's so many people. Bill Pullman is another one of our co-stars. He was in Cold Feet, and he's been in several films that are just not released yet. They're due to be out real soon. And probably by this time next year, we'll be quite the name.
I lived in Charlotte County. I came to Charlotte County when I was a little girl. I had signed some papers up there in the courthouse with some of my relatives. So, but I just knew it then as a long buggy ride.
I found Charlotte County to be very friendly. I think it's a beautiful place to be. Everybody has been very cooperative. All the extras are from Charlotte County, and they're really a terrific group of people, and we're enjoying them very much.
I wanted to see what was involved with filming, and it's been very interesting. I've enjoyed it.
I was with some other teachers that decided they would do it, so I just kind of came along with the crowd. And then when they called me, I thought it would be fun to be able to tell my grandkids and children that I had done something like this.
I really haven't had much of a summer vacation yet since we ended school just recently, but I think all the kids would be very envious of us. I see most of them standing outside the fences most of every day, and they give their arm to trade places with me. So it's been very nice in that regard, but this doesn't happen very often, and I think they realize that.
All in all, it's a shot at doing something different in the summer, and so here we are, learning experience. One of the things that I'm so struck by, and I want to bring home to my students, will be how something that appears to be so easy and so glamorous as an end product really takes a tremendous amount of repetitive effort and painstaking, boring job, and that they should roll that into their thinking to carry it into life, that everything requires a lot of hard work.
All right, what you're seeing now is a fake wall that we build, a fake house-looking structure. Now, the idea is that this courtroom is in a big town, i.e. Nashville, or someplace like that, the exterior of which we filmed in Lexington, so we're trying to make this all match. Now, we had to build these walls up here mostly to buffer and hide the 1992 reality behind it. The fencing that you see was all constructed by us. We've hung autumn leaves in the trees because this whole trial takes place in the fall. And we've put greens up along the fence, and again, it's all in an effort to disguise street signs, buildings, the video store, things that obviously don't play in 1867.
Yes, I think that
Charlotte County with the historical background we have, that the setting was real good to come here, and being that the movie was tobacco related, and we are in the heart of Old Virginia blueprint tobacco belt, and me, I am a tobacco grower and a tobacco warehouseman, and this has just fit right in with my everyday life.
I'm staying out there, out at Stanton Hill. And what else? I got to Fears Corners, and I got to Harrisburg, population 69. And what else? A lot of stuff. You can laugh. These are good people here. You see a map of all these little roads, it's a little hard to find your way around, but you get used to it after a while. No, it's good home country, good home food, too.
This is something where the entire citizenry has worked together. Our Board of Supervisors, County Administrator, my office. I think that this is absolutely a start. I think that the Film Commission now, for the first time, knows that Charlotte County is out here. I think they know and hopefully will be told by the production company that we have opened our doors to them, that we've extended far beyond the regions. They have asked for this, they've asked for a little of that. Basically, it's very quickly, within a matter of hours, we've been able to produce.
People in Charlotte County are very, very special people because they seem to be very connected to their town. They have a lot of pride in their town.